You can see Robert Beaming, he's got to actually reverse the direction of that steam engine. There is no transmission in the way of a reverse on a steam engine. He's going to actually reverse the direction on the engine, this K2575. This is a Hausen engine. He's a very good steam operator. Very seldom does he have to correct himself when he lines up with the flywheel on the separator.
Has he done this?
Now you can see the big drive belts right there, ladies and gentlemen. They weigh about 100 pounds. Usually two men on the car. See, they've got a block of wood to jostle the wheel once they get the right tension on the belt. About 45 seconds right now. 45 seconds right now. Jim lining up from the oil pole, the 4060. The house is steaming to the 4575. You get the belt up on the flywheel. And we've got a threshing machine, separators, spinning, woo! Too much tension, like everything's all right the way they like it. That's a minute at 26 seconds on steam. Very nicely done. All right, ladies and gentlemen, right at 2 minutes, right at 2 minutes, drop another half. That is when our teamsters can start hooking horses, and that's when it gets exciting. We bring the horses around the front, hook them up, and start picking up our field of stoops here. We're at a minute and 47, minute and 50. You're like 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Watch the hat. It's now. Let's hook some horses. All right, there are penalties for leaving the team and feeding the 2 second penalty. When you're on the green rack or the red flag, you better check and watch them very, very closely. Right now, steam is ahead of gas by about a minute, I think, in 59 seconds. We've got our first team getting hooked up there. The flag station, I think, may be out there first. No, it's going to be a bad perch run. Great team is on the roll here as well. All right, here comes Don McKee. He's actually going to be first out with a big black perch run. Sally is number 3, I believe. The Breezers are picking up. Roy Manns and McRae moving on number 4. And we are pitching bundles. Ladies and gentlemen, this is high speed, but this is exactly how it looked from about 100 years ago. From about 100 years ago, or about 50 years past that, but it's been years now. You can listen to our teamsters, ladies and gentlemen. They're talking to their teams all the time. They're moving forward. You can hear Woe, you can hear Gene, get up, all those kinds of things. Move forward from stoop to stoop, the pitching. And way on the far side, that's Roy Manns, and his pitcher is Gary Bucher. Well, they're doing a nice job today. Very, very even. This is going to be a close race on day number 3, or Saturday afternoon performance. Boy, with all those signals, but they listen to the man that broke them, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Arthur will only respond to his voice. Lots of work, boys. They're throwing it on. How about a round of applause as they do it? They're working hard out there. Don McKee was first one, and he's the first one out. Now we're going to start beating him into the threshing machine. There goes Roy Manns. He's got those grays working, trying to get him to turn around here as fast as he can. Here comes Chris Arthur. He's rolling on a green rock. And Jordan Nelson. Now we've got a few sheaves left on the field here. A few sheaves left on the field. Chris Arthur had some trouble getting close yesterday. He's gotten very close here today. Got the inside, we're going to start beating it through the separators. But we do have some penalty seconds. There are penalty seconds in the field. Not all the sheaves are picked up. That's my head. 2 seconds for every sheave left in the region. Glenn Beavish, the judge on the steam side. Chris Arthur, almost empty there. Don McKee has only got about another 10 sheaves to put through. They've got to put them through head first, but there's penalty seconds there. put his chief in backwards. It's penalty sessions at long. Boy, Chris is just about empty there. Dawn, only about another two or three to go. We've got Red Rack empty on the inside here. Roy Lamb is unloading as quickly as he possibly can. Looks like Martin Nelson is empty on closing to the grandstand. Good job, guys. They're going to get him set up. Running the last few sheaves through our separator, ladies and gentlemen. Just a few more to go. One green rack is empty. One is just about empty. One red rack empty. And another one getting very close to being empty. About 5 or 6 feet left of the second red rack at the end of the green rack. We've got very close range. 50 seconds is going to decide who wins day number three. We'll give you the total on 3 days here in just a moment. Four penalty seconds, under 7 minutes. Now this is one of our fastest ever days. The gas were done in 6 minutes and 50 seconds. 6 minutes and 50 seconds for gas. I mean, that's kicking. From the time they started setting the bells, they had to hook the horses, kick up the field, and feed it through the separator. We're going to get our official times in just a moment.